she had events just like this and all kinds of networking opportunities. And at that time, I was just starting to do my creativity and my art. And to have access to all kinds of women and men in the city as well as in other parts of the country come in, it really does enhance one's life. And this is what happens when you get exposed to that. You get someone like me. So I've had a lot of people feed into me, including my parents and my friends, and now new people that I'm meeting. So That Which Awakens Me is a poetic memoir, and it is filled with poems and reflections and prayers, and some people think some of it is meditation. There's creative exercises in the back. There's pieces of my artwork on the front as well as on the back. And then inside you've got some collages that you'll see and some photographs of my 8 archetypes. Yes, I have 8 parts of myself that I've been exploring over the last several years. And so That Which Awakens Me comes from Kiamsha, which is my creative name. And Kiamsha is a Swahili word that means That Which Awakens Me. And when I turned 27, I took that name because I was struggling with who I was, what did I think I was going to be doing, and the thoughts that I had from 16 up until then, they weren't manifesting. I spent 16 to 25 becoming a lawyer, and things didn't turn out the way that I thought they were going to be. And at 27, I hit a brick wall, and I had to figure out, okay, you got this plan, but what are you going to do? And creativity, writing poetry, and then a couple years later doing wire sculpture and eventually painting and drawing and collaging is what opened me up. And so I'm going to read from this book and then talk about my debut novel. And I'm going to take some questions. And you can stop me because this is a conversation. It's not just me up here doing my thing. So this is just about my creative birthing process. My creative birthing process is magical and messy. It's filled with dreams, memories, and realities that offer light and dark moments. It makes me run from my fears and celebrate my overcoming. It gives me great laughter and exposes me to deep pain. It forces me to pause in unexpected places. It reveals truths and wounds I do not want to know. It turns me inside out and serves as a catalyst for healing. As a result, I have become intimately acquainted with my vulnerabilities as a writer. It's confession time. My journal opens. I write a truth with revelations I'd rather not share. They bring me to a limitless crossroads. A choice must be made. I know I need to write it and see it in order to move through it. So I step onto the page naked. Without protection, my fingers cringe, but I write anyway. I write because it saves my life. And right now, I need to be my own savior, because I'm on the edge of self-sabotage. My pen touches the page reluctantly. She pauses before pressing into a moment that feels like a pre-Pandora's box, opening with wild and furious fears. I breathe in and out like the good yoga teacher I am. My eyes close. A tear invites itself into the corner of my right eye. Its twin appears in my left eye. Yin-yang revelations emerge. They marry. In celebration of their union, the ink flows from my pen. I take one more deep breath. Exhaling, I feel myself beginning to unravel. My vulnerabilities as a writer appear. I have nowhere to run, so I write. And so, this is me just trying to get through the memoir. And I reached a point in the process where stuff wasn't coming. And the stuff wasn't coming because I was resisting. I didn't want to tap into whatever was bubbling up in me. Because I learned from writing this book, which is not autobiographical, but it has a lot of my stuff in it. And the stuff I was writing about brought up my own stuff. So I was hesitant in this process because it does get messy, and I'm a control freak, and I wanted it to go a certain way, and it just didn't. that's that piece.